Are you Psalms 89? Yeah, 5 to 7.
And the heavens shall praise thy wonders.
What are you reading? Psalms.
Psalms 89.
82, sorry, 82 verse 5. Because that sounded like that. Yeah.
82?
Yeah, verse 5.
They know not, neither will they understand.
They know not. Church, listen to what he's reading. They know not, neither will they understand. Continue.
They walk only in darkness.
They all walk in darkness.
All the foundations of the earth are out of course.
Now listen carefully. The foundation of the righteous can never be destroyed. But the foundation of the righteous can be out of course. Let me show you an example. You see how this thing is built? You see how it's built now? What the Bible is saying is, the foundation of the righteous cannot be destroyed. But the foundation of the righteous can be out of course. This three bases are the foundation of this, right? The Bible is saying the problem with the righteous, their foundation is that when they are building it, they put this one instead of this place, they now go and put it here. So can this stand? You see now, you see what has happened? This chair is supposed to have four legs, but when you remove one of it and put under, what happens? You've not gotten, you see, if you get the major revelation in that scripture we're using now, you will be amazed. Now, what is happening? What is God telling us? God is telling us that the problem with Christians building their foundation, they don't want to count one, two, three. But how they live their life is, they want to, where are you now? One. What's the next thing you want? Is it a problem? That's what they're like. If the foundation of the righteous be destroyed, if you destroy your foundation, if you put it on, nobody is willing nowadays to pay. You see this thing we say, no pain, no gain, is very true. The Bible says, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. When God called Moses, he didn't tell him about wilderness. He told him, go and take my people from Egypt to Canaan. God can never tell you the wilderness in your vision. When he was telling Joseph, he never told Joseph he was going to enter into three prisons, three pits. He only told him, your people will worship you. God can never tell you the pains, the price to pay. He can never. But he will show you the promise. He's wiser than you. If he shows you the problem, you say, get out. The pain will pass through these 3 weeks. You know, the worst pain is when you are passing through pain, you can't share with anybody. You'll be dying within yourself. If the Lord doesn't encourage you, can't encourage. Because I'm a pastor. How can I belittle myself and start gossip? You know, living a life of gossip. If you ask me, I don't have such time. I'm not finished preaching what God told me. Are you getting my point now? The foundation of the earth. You see the man you are seeing here. Just try. Go with my CV, curriculum vitae. Go to ask other pastors. Can you just tell him, do you know Pastor Joseph? There's something I don't understand about this man. He told us with his mouth that he was ordained as a reverend minister in Junior Church of, as a Court of Law Mission in Nigeria. That this man is a pastor of the Church of Idahosa Church. And he has been under the church for 5 years before he was now ordained a reverend minister. 2005. By 2015, he will be 10 years, not as a pastor, but as a reverend minister. My next level now is right reverend. And after right reverend, my name is most reverend. That's our vision. And this man has planted a church, Church of God Mission, single-handedly in Malaysia. And this man, when he was coming to Australia, he came the same time with his family of three. No center link. No support from anywhere. My church, I started giving us $500, started last year. No support. I go to work when I have my job. My job starts by 2 o'clock a.m. cleaning job. I will clean it till 8 o'clock in the morning. So that I will still have time for ministry. Only for about $2,000. That's the hardest job I've ever done. That for more than 5 hours. If you see where I clean, I didn't know my boss was just using me. I will clean almost 3-story building for 7 hours for only $58. The cleaning job I'm applying for now, they pay $20 per hour. James, you know what I'm talking about? That was up, and you can hear it up to today. These people that are taking me around, talking all these things, are they wiser than Archbishop Bessie the host that I'm carrying around all her everywhere I'm going with her signature? Are they wiser than my leaders? Do you know what Jesus said in a situation like this? He said, even if you don't believe what he's saying, why not believe the work he has done? For by their fruits we shall know them. I'm not believing. Church, I'm only trying to say something. The problem we have is that we don't want to pay the full price so that we'll be able to stand. We only want only place for, you know, and so there are people that came to Australia. It's not up to, they're not up to 1 year now. But you that have stayed 20 years, they want to start wearing the same clothes you are wearing. The worst part of it, they are young girls. They are not yet married. But they will challenge you when you talk, you see their mouth problem. They will not check. This woman that is with her children still maintain upon all the challenges, upon all everything, they are still in good intact with the family and the husband. Do you think it's easy to live with the family, to live a family, to stay in the family? Yeah. Don't all these words you see here. Until they man. Now then mama will say, aha, now I can drop. There's no way she can have rest. See, we only have to, not to talk of. And this one, there's what we call agape age. You see the age they are in now. Nobody knows how to pass them. There's nothing you can tell them. They want to do every invention. They want to get everything. And you know how to get them. You don't get them with muscle. You get them with tolerance. You get them with much love now to direct them. It's only after this age now, sometimes they make mistake and enter into trouble. They will now say, oh, mama was true. But this time, there's nothing you can do to change them. Except love. That's agape age. It's youth age. Their head is anything they see now, they want to practice it. Anything. They are very sharp. They are very smart now. And you know, the heartbreak when they make mistakes, the mother sees, the father sees. It's not easy. Church, listen to what I'm saying. But if you take your time and pay the, if you enter, let's say this woman has been here 10 years, and you enter the first 1 year. And instead of you going to compete with her, you say, mama, please share your secret with me, I want to learn. Mama will start teaching you number one, number two, number three, number four, number five, number six, number seven. Before you know, you will already know you are a success. Number 8, number 9, number 10. When you come to her level, you will be greater than her. Am I lying? Simply. Even if you come to her 10 years. Because what? You like her secret. You had that with yours. The foundation of the Christians are destroyed. Anything, any mistake, any frustration that has made us to bring our foundation to the wrong place, I mean, bring it out of course, they shall be wiped away in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, are you sitting here? Let's finish it so that we pray. Yes, Psalms 82. You read 5. They will not understand. Yes.
I've said, yeah, God.
Now, listen very well. Then the people are saying, why is it that miracle is not happening in our life? Why is it that upon all our level, God is saying, because you don't want to count 1 to 3, you only want to jump from 1 to 5. Continue.
All of you are children of the Most High God.
You know you are gods. You are telling the people.
But ye shall die like men.
See, but because you don't know you are gods, you will die like men.
And fall like one of the princes.
Now listen very carefully. God is saying, you are the one killing yourself. You are God. But until you make your foundation right, forget about it in life. You will still, it's very practical. Go and build foundation with something that is not strong. Maybe you put something heavy. What happened? It falls. What happens again? You start again. Do it, brother. I don't know whether I'm making sense.
Yeah.
Listen. One of the greatest benefits we have as young people was we had Christian parents. You see what the Bible says, turn up the guy in the way to go. There's something, I want to advise you. If you can know God earlier than me, you will rule your world. For with God, all things happen. If you can serve God, hey, look at us, we are all growing old now. Yeah. But what we have to do now is to make sure we bless our children. You will see, you be a shining light. Don't jump foundations. Learn everything you need to learn. Follow every step that you have been taught. Now, let me tell you what happens. If you have wrong foundation and armed robbers, thief want to steal what belongs to you, they will succeed. If you have wrong foundation, any attack that comes to you will cripple you. Stand up. You see, whatever we are building, every mother, their heart desire is that our children will grow. You are our target, never your target. There is not a joy you have except for this. So we are going to pray. You will stand on the right foundation forever you like. No power will move you away from the right foundation. Just begin to thank God for Jesus being our foundation. Lord, we thank you for being our foundation. Lord, we thank you for being our foundation. Thank God I know God. Thank God I'm a child of God. Thank God I'm called by God. Thank God God is true. Thank God God is faithful. Thank God Rabbo Shaka Baba Baba. And Rabbo Shaka Tora Baba Baba. Excuse me, man. Nobody should teach the Holy Spirit. Should advise the Holy Spirit. I want you to make our time. You and my wife, you go and open an account for Quiffy. If not for any other thing, you open an account for Quiffy, then we start from there. Because Quiffy is another thing God is telling us. Quiffy was the people that organized the Mother's Day. Quiffy is about women. It's about the welfare of women. It's about women, family, the parents of women, prayer, everything. We are in a community where we don't really want to do anything financially with that. So the money they got on the Mother's Day is supposed to use to open an account for Quiffy. Again, the point, it's not part of the church. It's different, but it's under the church. It's an outreach for women. So I wouldn't want that money to still remain in our house. You know? I want that with you, even if for any other thing, let it be that you are doing it with her for the interest. You understand? So that we just get that off our neck. You understand? So she will communicate with you and you guys will just go open an account with it. You understand what I mean? Quiffy is, I'll show you the whole letter, everything. It's the ministry, our, in fact, the way we do it is, I am in charge of the church, my wife is in charge of Quiffy. So Church of God Mission, our women are also pastors. They handle other things. So my wife is the president of Quiffy in Australia. You see the point now? But she cannot, she always needs women leaders to support her. You understand? But not as if I'm appointing you as a, but I have a leading. You understand? Do this because we are still gathering ourselves up. so that we just get that account, get that money, because it must be signed between you and her. I mean, two of you must sign before you bring out the money, so that we know that one is settled. Because I knew what I'm saying, the day we were counting the money, I know how the church was looking. I know by now they would have been going everywhere now. You know, whether we have eaten the money again since Pastor Joseph came. But I want it to be done so that you will be aware. At least you can be an approved that the money we got on the Mother's Day, which is meant for Wifi, that you are part of the account that have been opened, that you are aware of it, and pastor's wife cannot sign the money without you. That's what we want to establish, because we are in a hot seat now. In the same society, we have blessed so many people. People are carrying us around as death, but it doesn't matter. Time shall tell. You understand? So we want to secure this path. So I want us to open our mouth now and begin to pray. Lord, every evil foundation that the enemy has thrown against us, every evil foundation that the enemy has thrown against us, Lord, we destroy it with the blood of Jesus. We destroy every foundation. Let me have a holy.